In this video, I'd like to introduce a couple of very interesting circuits, one that can differentiate signals and one that can integrate signals. These are useful when, for example, you want to convert from one kind of waveform to another kind of waveform, like from a square wave to a sawtooth wave or back. Let's take a look at the circuits. They're actually really simple circuits. The only difference between the differentiator and the integrator is the position of the resistor and the capacitor. The actual value of the resistor and the capacitor don't matter too much because it's just a constant that sits in front of the differential or a constant that just sits in front of the integral. I'd now like to derive these equations from first principles. We're going to be assuming ideal op-amps here. Since the non-inverting pin is grounded, as long as the op-amp is working as we expect it to, then this node should also be 0 volts. Let's label this current I, and then this current also needs to be I because none of the current's going to split off into the inverting pin. The first current going through this capacitor is given by C dV over dt, and V here is just the voltage at the input. That same current passes through the resistor. Ohm's law gives us minus VO over R. It's negative because the arrow points from zero towards positive voltage. If I solve this equation for the output voltage, I find that the output voltage is just a constant times a differentiation of the input voltage. Let's now move on to the integrator. We have almost the same setup here. The voltage at the non-inverting node is 0 volts, so the voltage here at the inverting node ought to be 0 volts too, provided that the op-amp is functioning as we expect it to. Let's call this current I, and it's just the input voltage divided by R. That's going to be equaling the current through this capacitor over here. The current is C dV dt, and the voltage across this capacitor is negative VO. Since the input voltage is related to the time derivative of the output voltage, if I want to isolate the output voltage, I just need to take the integral in order to do that. If we assume that the output voltage starts at 0 volts and rises to some value, V out, then the right side of this equation is just minus V out. Let's assume that the initial value for the output voltage, which I'm calling 0, corresponds to time t 0. We can then say that the final value for the voltage, VO, corresponds to the final time, which I'm going to call t 1. We then need to integrate with respect to time between t 0 and t 1 in order for this to make sense. These two values in the black boxes are just equal to one another. That completes the derivation of the relationship between output voltage and input voltage for both the differentiator and the integrator.